Hey, what is going on, guys? No, that's the wrong channel. Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Shannon Steam. Now, I'm going to welcome you to a little bit of something you may not have expected. This is R2 Sturmovik Battle of Stalingrad. Now, up here it says Battle of Moscow as well. That's because I bought the DLC for it. And, hold on, I gotta get my bar out of the way real fast. Let's put that down a small bit. There we go. Okay, so we're going to be doing a little bit of some in the career mode. Now, it's going to be similar to the Slovak-Hungarian War video that I did, like, early last year. So, let's get into it, and I'll show you what I'll be doing. I'll be doing a new career. I'm not going to do the Battle of Moscow, because I'm going to do that in a later series. So, we're going to go to the Battle of Stalingrad. Okay. Got the Soviet Union, I got Germany. So I'm gonna go with the Soviet Union. Okay, lag city for some reason. Okay, the aircraft that I have is the I-16, the MiG-3, the Yak-1, the U-2VS, the PE-2, the Ilyushin-2, the LAG-3. The LA-5. Now, this is an early model LA-5, so it's not going to perform to its highest standards. So that's essentially it right there. I'm going to try my best to unlock all the other planes. Well, I gotta buy them. Now, I thought for this first one, I would just do a fighter campaign. Now, I can't do this one because it's almost impossible. So, I'm gonna go with the 11th Squadron, I think. You know, what's the 811th? Oh. Okay, that's an IL-2 Squadron. Oh, I deselected it. There we go. Okay, let's fly that one. Okay, let's find the right portrait that I'm looking for. Yeah. You don't really get to select the portraits. So, sorry about that. Hey, nice mustache. Yeah, these bland ass photographs. Yeah, I might as well settle for this one. Okay, I'm, change my background to Soviet educated pilot. And I'm going to do from beginning for commanding of the unit. Do it that way. Okay, let's wait for it to materialize. Yep, there we go. I'm gonna skip this because I'm sure a lot of you might have played this game. Well, if not, then I might show you the video next time. So, we're gonna start with the advance on the Volga. Okay. Okay, next day. Okay, a new day begins. Yeah, I'm sure it does. And I think I might have said this before, but everything's going to be on the same settings as it was in IL-2 Sturmovik 1946. So anyway, let's continue on. Well, I got the aviation badge for doing nothing. That's weird. Okay, let's proceed. Okay, river crossing. Nice contrails. Here, let me move my mic a little bit closer. Enemy planes have been spotted crossing our front lines. Alright. Let's start the mission. Of course, we gotta customize our aircraft. And for some reason, it'll air spawn us. Yeah, loading screens are a little long, at least on my end. On, you're getting there. There we go. Okay, let's go to the primary setup. Okay, we got a female pilot here. And there's our pilot name right here, Lydia. I wrote that. Now it's just a fighter mission, so I'm not going to be carrying any loads today. Okay, paint scheme. And yes, I got a lot of paint schemes. But I won't be selecting any of those. So that'll do. Let's get airborne. And until I hit any combat, I'll be using autopilot to reach the target. Aircraft. Get a better look at it. This is a Captain One, the same one controlled by Lydia, but that's the pilot that's there. Back out. It looks like there's a football up ahead. I'm gonna speed up time and get there. Yeah, it's kind of a beautiful countryside, the area next to the Volga. Excuse me. And yes, like I say, I have infinite ammo on and just everything. But the only difference between this game and 1946 is that your controls will not always respond the way you want them to. For instance, well, this gameplay is pretty similar to Rise of Flight. I've covered that on the channel a couple of times, and those are actually some of my first videos, so I encourage you to go check those out. Just go to my video section on my channel, and they should be at the very bottom. Yeah, you should be able to see them. You can't miss them. Okay, let's get a little bit closer. Then I'll disengage the speed. Okay, good. Autopilot off. Oh, jeez. You almost did. That's not a little bit. That was too close. Yeah, it's got four. Maybe 109 out of four. Wait. My target should be the bombers. I don't know why I'm going for the fighters. Not fighters. Well, what kind of bombers are they? Oh no, I think those are just ground attackers. Vector on him. Oh, fly the car first there. I don't know. Now, just like the 46, I don't have this. Oh, jeez, I almost fly the wings. I gotta chop back on the power. Easily out of turn. You cannot find me. You might have to go silent for a second. What? Goes on? Why'd you cross the front like that? One. I was wrong. That was enough four. For some reason, whenever the laser shots come in head on, they always look like they're mixed up. G2. Now concentrate. My guns around this guy. Slow down real fast. Slow gain speed. Come on. Forced landing, okay. Well, shot down 7 aircraft on my first run, so that's ace in a day. 21 minutes, 30 seconds. I'd say that's pretty good. Okay, let's see what happens. Okay. Oh. Man. Order of the Red Star. Okay. Order of the Red Banner. Fire kill bonus, that's 1,000 rubles. I shot down 7 of those, so I'm gonna get 6 more of these. Okay. Come on. There we go. Alright, well, that's going to be it for this first video. Now, if you want to see more IL-2 Sturmovik on the channel, let me know down in the comments. And also, smash that like button. That'll let me know that you really enjoyed it. So, in the meantime, peace.